We have all been told not to go swimming or stand in puddles during a thunderstorm. This is because water is a good conductor of electricity. Electrical currents flow easily in a good conductor. But rubber boots could save you. Rubber, as opposed to water, resists the flow of electrical current. In science terms, we say rubber has a high resistivity. Conductivity and resistivity are inverses of each other. If material has high conductivity, it has low resistivity. And high resistivity means low conductivity. Geophysicists measure the resistivity of soil and rock below the Earth's surface to solve problems. For example, if you are hired to drill a well to supply water to a small town, how can you determine the best place to drill to reach a good groundwater layer? Remember, electrical currents flow easily through water because water does not provide much resistance to electrical currents. Again, water has low electrical resistivity. In contrast, solid rock has a high resistivity. Beneath the surface of the Earth, some rock units are intact, while others are riddled with cracks of fractures. And these fractures can be filled with water. Electrical current flows more easily through the water-filled fractures than through the rock. The more fractures a zone of rock has, the higher the conductivity and the lower the resistivity of that zone. For a water supply well, the best place to drill is into rock with a lot of fractures because a pump can easily draw water up through the fractures. So, the best place to drill will be a rock layer with low electrical resistivity. How can we, at the surface, use electricity to find a layer with low resistivity? One way is to use a geophysical method called electrical resistivity tomography, or ERT. In an ERT survey, geophysicists use an instrument that drives low voltage electrical currents through the ground to measure how much resistance the current encounters. Every measurement requires four metal stakes pushed into the ground, called electrodes. Two electrodes are used to drive current. The other two are used for taking a reading of the electrical potential, that is, the difference in their voltage. This gives a rough average of the resistivity in the area of current flow. The ERT system is designed to be connected to many electrodes. The unit is programmed to drive current and measure voltage between sets of electrodes, in sequence, over many different flow paths. The farther apart the current electrodes are, the deeper the current flows. By the end of this process, measurements have been made that are sensitive to different depths and to different locations beneath the string of electrodes. Finally, all these readings are put together. A computer runs a calculation called an inversion that determines a resistivity depth profile that would produce all the measured values. The resistivity profile shows areas underground with higher resistivities and lower resistivities. Back to our question of where to drill. Recall that the fractured rock that will be easiest to pump from will have a low resistivity. The ERT profile shows a low resistivity zone here. It's shallowest at this location, so this is a spot where it appears that you wouldn't have to drill as deeply to find the pumpable groundwater. However, we need to be careful, because multiple factors can impact the resistivity. It's true that the more fractured the rock, the lower the resistivity if there is water in the fractures. But a pollution plume could produce a similar ERT profile, even in uniformly fractured rock. This is because contaminated water has lower resistivity than clean groundwater. It is essential to consider other geological and environmental data in addition to ERT. So, it's best to have a general idea of what to expect before making a geological interpretation of the resistivity profile. Here are some other scenarios where ERT surveys can be useful. Unsaturated soil has higher resistivity than the same soil, saturated, so a resistivity survey can help locate the depth of the water table. Saltwater has an extremely low resistivity. so ERT is a good method for locating the freshwater-saltwater interface on coastlines. An air-filled cave will have a very high resistivity, so scientists have used ERT to map caves from the surface. When interpreted with care, ERT surveys can also be used for assessing the influence crops and trees have on groundwater, finding contaminant plumes from landfills or mining, because the more conductive areas, those with low resistivity, may indicate polluted groundwater, and locating impermeable clay layers that block groundwater movement, at those layers will appear as zones of very low resistivity. In conclusion, ERT can be used in a wide variety of urban and rural settings to learn valuable information about the subsurface in fields including hydrology, geology, environmental science, and engineering. Thank you.